Metaverse. You must be hearing this term quite regularly on social media platforms or on the news these days. Some of you must have heard it for the first time when Facebook changed its name to Meta in November 2021 to enter the world of the Metaverse. Since then, we have seen Metaverse becoming a hot trend around the world. Justin Bieber recently hosted a concert in the Metaverse where he performed his latest album as his digital avatar replicated him, and thousands of people around the world attended it. Not only this, an Indian couple decided to get married in the Metaverse, and one couple also threw their wedding reception in the Metaverse. And to think of it, since large gatherings with thousands of guests are not allowed because of the ongoing pandemic, it sounds like a brilliant idea to host a wedding in the Metaverse than in the real world. You don't even have to wear masks or worry about catching the virus or even decide what to wear. But most importantly, all of this shows that Metaverse will become mainstream sooner than we may imagine. It has already started to make a place in our online world globally and in India. So the entry of Metaverse in our online life is going to be much smoother than people think. But what is Metaverse? What is so exciting about it? How do we use it? Why do we need it? And how will it affect our life? If you're intrigued about these questions, then stay tuned till the end of this video as I will explain you everything about this crazy virtual world. Now, since Metaverse is yet to become a complete reality, there is no ideal definition that can explain it. So just imagine, it's 2035, there is an online world where there are digital versions of everything around us. People, houses, land, daily use objects, your office, school, stores, market, playing area, and everything else that pretty much makes up our real world. It's like a virtual copy of a real world. You can even buy and sell things, just not in cash, but with cryptocurrency and NFTs. And anyone can enter this 3D virtual world through their phone, virtual headset, AR glasses, or similar advanced gadgets. Well, that's Metaverse in a nutshell. Now let's get into its details. So currently we use the internet in two dimensions. We use our phones, laptops, tablets to access the internet, to read, write, play, and interact online. We can text, make an audio or video call to talk to people and socialize, right? But in Metaverse, we will be using the internet in 3D. We will be able to virtually interact with people in digital representations of people, places and things. It's almost like watching a movie in 3D where you can virtually experience the movie, as if you're literally inside the scenes and it feels like you are a part of it. Not in reality, but virtually. So if the internet is a place, then Metaverse is simply a highly immersive 3D version of it. You can do anything that you do in the current online world. But in Metaverse, you will be in the middle of the action. You can play games, hang out with your friends, catch up with your colleagues, buy lands, try out new clothes, attend events, concerts, and whatnot. But what makes Metaverse different from the current internet is that you will experience everything in 3D. This next generation internet is made up of virtual reality, augmented reality, artificial intelligence, social media, online gaming, and cryptocurrencies. Okay, all of these realities might sound confusing to you right now, since the Metaverse could still take another 5 to 10 years to go mainstream. So let me give you some current real-life examples of the Metaverse to help you understand the concept in the simplest way possible. Also, if you're enjoying this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel and share this video with others. First, 3D avatars. So currently, we all have profile pictures on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, or Twitter. But in Metaverse, we will all have our very own 3D avatars, which will be able to copy our expressions and movements. In fact, something similar is already available to us right now, like on an iPhone. We have Memojis that can copy our facial expressions. There are avatars in Snapchat as well that look like us. We can change our clothes, hair, makeup, and make them look the way we want our avatar to look like. So the way we currently are obsessed with Instagram or Facebook pictures, we will make an effort to make our 3D avatar look the best. Secondly, with current internet platforms, if you want to talk to your colleagues or attend an online class, you get on a video calling app and talk to them virtually. And we all know how boring it gets sometimes, right? Because it is not that immersive. It does not give us the feeling of actually being with them. But in Metaverse, you will be able to virtually be with them, interact with them in a more immersive way, where your avatar can sit with people in virtual office space or digital classrooms. For example, you will be able to give a high five to your friend in the Metaverse, and they will be able to feel it in reality with the help of a sensation-based glove or a similar gadget. So it will be much more immersive and fun to interact online. And to make it happen, tech companies are already working on building such platforms. Microsoft has already announced two such products. One is the Mesh app, where you can view in 3D and All Space VR, which will be used to hold meetings in virtual reality. Third, Metaverse is boundless. There are no limits as to how many people can use it at the same time, what you can do in the Metaverse, and what industries can enter it. Gaming, real estate, entertainment, fashion, and live events to corporate. All the industries will have something to offer in the Metaverse. So like today, if you want to buy a house, you have to physically go to that place and take a look at it. But in Metaverse, you will be able to wear your AR glasses and virtually move around the house to look at it. Let me give you another example. So if you want to buy something online today, you take a look at its pictures, videos, or maybe a 3D version of it. But in Metaverse, you will be able to enter the store virtually and see everything in 3D, which will make the shopping experience much more immersive. Like today, you can go on Lenskart's website and try on the glasses without physically going to the store. Now, there are many more real-world problems that will be solved by the Metaverse. But how will it affect our online life? Now, change is always scary. But the entry of Metaverse into our lives might not be as dramatic as people may think. It will definitely change the way we use the internet today. But Metaverse is not too far from becoming a reality. Some of its use cases can already be seen in our daily lives. Also, since we already spend a lot of time online or in the digital world because of the pandemic, the Metaverse will slowly be a part of our online lives in a much smoother way than we think. But we can't completely ignore the risks involved, right? So with Metaverse, we might become more disconnected from our physical world. It might become an escape from our social life, as we will be able to do much more in the Metaverse than we can do with the current internet. Some of us might not be able to differentiate between the Metaverse and our real world and get too comfortable with their virtual avatars than their real self. Now, it is only a matter of time before the Metaverse becomes an expansive, fully functional ecosystem like the internet today. But for it to get there, it will have to overcome all these challenges and many more. So that's all for Metaverse for now. I'm quite excited to see what this next generation of the internet holds for us. Let me know what are your thoughts on Metaverse. And as always, keep following Gadgets 360 for more videos on tech. I will see you in the next one.